Ever since the United States was formed, people from all over the world have been coming to its shores in droves. These huddled masses may have been fleeing poverty, religious persecution, or political tyranny. Perhaps they were searching for a land where they could simply start life anew. Regardless of their reasons for coming, immigrants have had a profound effect on our nation for hundreds of years, and many have become extremely successful, occupying the highest government positions, creating powerful business empires, and generally changing America for the better. In this documentary, I will be examining immigration in both a modern and historic context. We will examine the influences of Irish, Italian, Chinese, and Hispanic immigrants. Many groups, too many to name, are not covered, although be reminded that is not reflective of their importance to our nation. We begin with thousands of impoverished farmers on the Emerald Isle. Let's take a look. Many Irish left their country after the 1845 potato famine killed off the potato crop and destroyed the nation's economy. Many of the Irish immigrants were farmers by trade, but were forced to take up factory work in American cities. Irish immigrant Henry Ford later introduced the assembly line system, which, aside from changing American industry forever, allowed for improved working conditions and higher wages in factories. Irish Americans also became a very strong group in politics, due to their strength of community and their common tie to the Catholic Church. One notable example of an Irish American politician is, of course, President John F. Kennedy. The same strength of organization helped the Irish to form strong labor unions, a legacy still very much relevant today. The Italians came over to America in one great migration between 1880 and 1922. They left Italy for a number of reasons. The country was poverty-stricken, the newly formed government was weak, and many were tired of being sharecroppers. Upon arrival, nearly all Italian immigrants passed through Ellis Island, although to them it was known as the Island of Tears, for family members deemed too unhealthy could be sent home by the inspectors. About one-third of Italian immigrants stayed in New York City, and many stayed together, forming tight-knit communities in the sprawling city. Through determination, a strong work ethic, and the help of Italian-American organizations, like the Sons of Italy, two-thirds of Americans with Italian descent have white-collar jobs, making up a large amount of the nation's doctors, lawyers, professors, and businessmen and women. The story of Chinese immigration begins in 1848 with rumors of discovered gold at Souther's Mill in California. Thousands of people from all over the United States and the world ran to California to stake out their claim. Chinese immigrants originally came to make a fortune and return to China, although many stayed in California, where they opened businesses or went into agriculture or fishing. The Chinese also played a major part in the construction of the Transcontinental Railroad. The Central Pacific Railroad was at first hesitant to hire foreigners, although after contractor Charles Crocker hired 50 Chinese workers, he was so impressed that he sent agents to recruit more men in China. In the end, the railway was completed 7 years ahead of the government's deadline. Chinese Americans have made great strides in many different fields, with notable individuals like Maya Lin, who designed the Vietnam Veterans Memorial, and Stephen Chu, Nobel Prize winner for physics and current Secretary of Energy. Hispanic immigrants are, by definition, any person who comes to America from a Latin American country. America has seen thousands of Cuban immigrants who left their country after dictator Fulgencio Batista was overthrown by communist leader Fidel Castro. The first wave of these immigrants was filled with the professional elite of Cuba, who have seen large degrees of success in America. Another subgroup of Hispanic Americans are Puerto Rican Americans. Since 1917, all residents of Puerto Rico have been citizens of America, and Puerto Rico has been an American Commonwealth since 1952. This has made travel and immigration between the two much easier. As a result, Puerto Rican influences are very strong in America. America has had a very unique relationship with other Hispanic immigrants. The Mexican-American War ended with the Treaty of Guadalupe Hidalgo. This was a peace treaty signed by both nations that ended in the Mexican Cession, in which half of Mexico's lands were sold to the United States. In this area, there already lived tens of thousands of Mexican citizens who, almost overnight, were closed within the borders of America. Although most early Hispanic immigrants worked on farms and the railroads, the current generation has risen up to high levels of success. For as long as there has been immigration, there has been opposition to it. Many immigrants were discriminated against because they were seen as stealing jobs by working for lower wages. In the 1850s, the American, or Know Nothing Party, ran Millard Fillmore as their presidential candidate on the platform of keeping immigrants out. Congress adjusted to this wave of nativism, passing laws like the Chinese Exclusion Act, which banned all Chinese immigration until 1943, and the Immigration Act of 1924, which created strict quotas and limited immigration across the board. The position of American immigrants improved after fighting heroically in World War II, and the resulting increase in work. A new immigration debate is going on right now. Should we legalize illegal immigrants, or should we find a way to deport them? This clip looks at legalization's effect on the economy.
There will be $1.5 trillion in economic growth over the next 10 years. If there's a legalization program, wages will go up for both native-born and for the legalized immigrant workers. If there's a legalization program, there will be an increase in tax revenue over the next 3 years, totaling $4.5 to nearly $5.5 billion.
Immigrants have clearly had an enormous impact on America, whether by revolutionizing industry, building cities, opening up frontiers, or rising to some of the highest positions in our nation. They have forged lives for themselves, defied opposition, and transformed America into the great nation that it is.